What's up, YouTube? This is Inventory King, bringing a video to everybody today on something that saved the majority of my fish back when I was getting into the hobby. I had done a deep clean on my aquarium. I sifted through the sand to pull out rock debris that I didn't want, did that in tank water. I had washed out my filters. I had done this before in sink water, which is, I know now, a big no-no. I'm not afraid to admit I made a mistake. Do that in tank water and never had a problem. But here's where I figured out where the problem was. By going through that sand so much, I feel that I got rid of so much beneficial bacteria that there wasn't enough in there to compensate for cleaning out the filters. This caused a major problem in my aquarium. After I had finished cleaning, I went out and hung out with some friends, and phone was on silent. Apparently I was getting phone calls and voicemails and texts. You gotta call me, something's going on with your fish. Well, luckily, they got in touch with somebody else I was with who answered the phone and gave me the phone. First thing, your fish are dying. Naturally, any fish keeper who knows their fish are dying, they're going to do whatever it takes. I rushed home and fish were laying on their sides. Some fish were still upright, swimming, all on the bottom, just major, major problems. I hope that everybody else can use what I'm about to say to keep themselves prepared in case something like this happens. When I got home, water changes like crazy. I went and, water change, let it sit for a little while. Water change, let it sit for a little while. Water change, let it sit for a while. And on my test, the ammonia and the nitrites were barely going down. When I first tested it, they were off the charts. It was insane. I knew my tank crashed. So after doing that for a while, I had a bright idea. Well, I keep some breeding groups, and in those tanks, I have sponge filters. Well, sponge filters are a great area for beneficial bacteria to grow. So I decided, why not grab one of my established filters from one of my breeding groups? I usually have a few in each tank because I like having a few. Put it in the 55 and plugged in the pump, got it going. I want to say 20 minutes or so, give or take, the fish that did not die yet were starting to move around. They were starting to swim around, and I could instantly see a difference in their behavior. And I know it's because I put that sponge filter in there that was established with beneficial bacteria to help combat the ammonia and the nitrites, so that this tank, not this one, but the 55 gallon tank that I had before this, could settle down. If you have extra tanks, buy some sponge filters. In the description below, I'm going to have a link to Amazon on the sponge filters that I use. They're inexpensive, they work great, and run them in some of those tanks that are not your show tanks. If you like sponge filters in your show tanks, awesome. If you don't like sponge filters in your show tanks and you have some other aquariums, put them in there. Let that beneficial bacteria grow on those sponges, because that sponge filter is what saved my fish when I had this issue at least over a year ago. That is what I wanted to share with you guys. Have a sponge filter on hand ready to go, because if you have a tank crashing for any reason, you know, you notice your fish are sluggish, you check your water test and you see you got high ammonia or nitrite, you do your water changes and it does not go down and you still notice something, throw in that sponge filter and there can make all the difference. I'm no expert, but this is what worked for me when I was in a crisis situation. Let me know what you guys think. Has this ever happened to you? Have you done this? What have you done when you've come across this situation where your tank is crashing on you? I lost probably about 7 to 10 fish, and I saved probably, 4 to 6, I think. So yeah, I lost more than I had, but it could have been, they could have all died. I hope that you guys find this video helpful. Again, let me know down in the comments what you guys think. Subscribe, like, and stay tanked.